بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، سيدنا وحبيبنا وقائدنا سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين. أما بعد، أيها الإخوة والأخوات، تقبل الله منا ومنكم الصيام والقيام وتلاوة القرآن، وجعلنا من المرحومين والمغفور لهم ومن عتقاء هذا الشهر من النار. Oh Allah, the Almighty, we are all praying to you at this moment that you accept our fasting and our prayer at night and humble our heart and have mercy upon us. Forgive us and make us among those they will be free from the hellfire. This time I want to continue with you, brothers and sisters, on the second segment of what we need to do in the community. As I said, Allah the Almighty said to all of us, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. And also he said, وَأَمْرُهُمْ شُورًا بَيْنَهُمْ. So Allah commanded us to grab tight to the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which means to come together and be a strong allies, coordinate, cooperate for the welfare of a community. And Allah said that we have a council to sit down and really dialogue and converse to see what is the best in the matters of the affairs of the people that we as believers in charge in helping, in charge in managing and organizing. I said that most of the mosques and centers in this region at this time, it has a background base maybe on the old immigration, recent immigration, what have in terms of calamity and disasters happen. So that the mosques that we look at has a background, whether based on nationalities or movement that they follow. So people, all of you, we command you to donate. We command you to support. We command you to do this program, that program. And on the top of all of this, we want to support the entire world from this small centers of mosques. And yet, a disaster like coronavirus, COVID-19 happened, everything shut. People, they don't have jobs. People, they do ask to support and help for food to manage. Yes, the government did help, put so many programs, but I am talking particularly about the Islamic centers, mosques, and organization. Why we did not plan? We always want you to support our programs and our organizations, and yet the organizations, they did not come together and organize what they have in terms of asset to manage your affairs. You come and donate the money, but you can't ask where my money are going. And I want you to take this responsibility, because what we are planning today for the generations to come, day after day. And what really make our resources so weak that we don't think to establish an endowment department, an endowment that will sit down, manage the financial assets, help invest, and help support these organizations if anything happened, like this pandemic. So they will maintain, instead of what you say many times over, we don't want to depend on somebody else's money. So, having said that, I want you to think about what I'm saying, to support, to have your vote that all the assets that we have, and I will say the number, we have more than $55 million asset. Where? Count them. All the mosques and centers that we built, all these properties that you have, these assets is the Muslim assets, and you are responsible for it. So if you push to establish an endowment department to manage, to help in all level, and in many areas, whether in a domestic relation to establish the services for all of you, in academic for the welfare of the community. PR also is very important, giving scholarship to see what's going on in the community, and support the mosques and centers by employing those they are there to manage and pray and proclaim for the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You do not want, especially those organizations who belong to this movement, that party, or this party, to manage the house of Allah, because the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is for him. لا تدعوا مع الله أحدا إن المساجد لله فلا تدعوا مع الله أحدا. But who takes care of that? The masajid, the mosque, is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we do not use it and take advantage of it to support this party or that party. Second, إنما يعمر مساجد الله من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر. So, those they are taking care of the mosque, those they are a real believer, sincere believer in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who try to work on for two reasons. As the hadith of the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, among the servants that they will be in the shadow of Allah in the hereafter, رَجُلٌ قَلْبُهُ مُعَلَّقٌ بِالْمَسَاجِدِ, a man, his heart is attached to the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to manage, to clean, to prepare, to organize, and to help the affairs of Muslims. Second, for all of us, مَنْ بَنَى لِلَّهِ بَيْتًا بَنَى اللَّهُ لَهُ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ. So, don't you want to see how your house in the heaven is being managed? Please, brothers and sisters, vote and tell the organizations that we are working for to get united, to get organized, so we do not have to go through the hardship financially as we are going today through this special circumstances of the pandemic COVID-19. Brothers and sisters, I pray for all of you because I love you, and I might not be among you that long. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you and I, because we have to work for the hereafter. And what I'm calling you today to do is not just only for this dunya. Yes, you organize and you have all of this to be managed in a professional manners and ways, but this way is for the hereafter. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for His Prophet, who commanded us, and the first things He did, He built a house in Medina, and this is what we call the house of the Prophet, Masjidun Nabiyyi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah, the Almighty, put a house and said to you, Inna awwala baytin wudi'a lin-nasi allazi bi-Bakkata mubarakun, that the first house that Allah put for men to worship Allah and ignite all the highest conduct of morals in the society is from the house of Allah. So please, brothers and sisters, have it in your heart to care for the houses of Allah and vote for all of the imams to come together and get united to establish the endowment department in the state of Michigan so we could organize all of our mosques. May Allah bless you. May Allah reward you. May Allah accept your fasting, your dua, and your humble heart and your sadaqah. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Ramadan Mubarak.